So we have some tables here that give us what the function f, what the functions f and g are when you give it certain inputs. So when you input negative 4, f of negative 4 is 29. That's going to be the output of that function. And so we have that for both f and g. And what I want to do is evaluate two composite functions. I want to evaluate f of g of 0. And I want to evaluate g of f of 0. So like always, pause the video and see if you can figure it out. Well, let's first think about f of g of 0. F of g of 0. What is this all about? And actually, let me use multiple colors here. F of g of 0. Well, this means that we're going to evaluate g at 0. So we're going to input 0 into g. Let me do it in that. So we're going to input 0 into our function g. And we're going to output, whatever we output is going to be g of 0. I'll write it right over here. And then we're going to input that into our function f. We're going to input that into our function f. And whatever I output then is going to be f of g of 0, f of g of 0, f of g of 0. I wrote these small here so we have space for the actual values. So first, let's just evaluate. And if you are now inspired, pause the video again and see if you can solve it all. Although if you solved it the first time, you don't have to do that now. Well, what's g of 0? Well, when we input x equals 0, we get g of 0 is equal to 5. So g of 0 is 5. So that is 5. So we're now going to input 5 into our function f. We're essentially going to evaluate f of 5. So when you input 5 into our function, I'll do it in this brown color. When you input x equals 5 into our f, you get the function f of, or you get f of 5 is equal to 11. So this is going to be 11. So f of g of 0 is equal to 11. Now, let's do g of f of 0. So now let's evaluate. I'll do this in different colors. G, maybe I'll use those same two colors actually. So now we're going to evaluate g of f of 0. G of f of 0. And the key realization is you want to go within the parentheses, evaluate that first, so then you can evaluate the function that's kind of on the outside. So here, we're going to take 0 as an input into the function f. And then whatever that is, that f of 0, we're going to input into our function g. We're going to input into our function g. And what we're going to be, and then the output of that is going to be g of f of 0. So let's see, what is f of 0? Well, you see over here, when our input is 0, this table tells us that f of 0 is equal to 1. So f of 0 is equal to 1, f of 0 is equal to 1. So now we use 1 as an input into g. We're now evaluating g of 1. So I can just write this. This is the same thing as g of 1, g of 1. Once again, why was that? Because f of 0 is equal to 1. And let me, I wrote those parentheses too far away from the g. This is the same thing as g of 1, because once again, f of 0 is 1. Now what is g of 1? Well, when I input 1 into our function g, I get g of 1 is equal to 8. So this is equal to 8, and we're done. And notice, these are different values, because these are different composite functions. F of g of 0 is 11, and g of f of 0 is 8.